Hey, what's happening, though? It's YG. You watching Under the Gun TV.
What it do, it's your boy DJ Mustard. You watching Under the Gun TV.
Bitch! Bitch! Fuck! Pussy! No, bro.
So the new album, My Crazy Life, came out in March. How crazy have the last few weeks been? I know you've been on the road everywhere. Packed out stadiums so long.
Yeah, cool. Man. We ain't doing stadiums yet. Yeah. Well, we did like two events that had like 10,000 people.
We doing stadiums this summer, though.
Yeah, we in stadiums this summer.
We doing all the summer jams. All of them.
On the come up, though. We on the grind. The tour been great, though. Feel me? Everybody lead the show, loving the show. Because it's just not a regular show. It's not a regular performance. It's a real show. Yeah.
There's a ton of established rappers out there who claim that you guys are bringing new life to the whole West Coast hip hop scene. When you went into the studio to record the album, did you consciously try to step it up to a new level, or did you just go in and do what you always did?
When I went up in there, you feel me? My motive was to get it back how I remember when we was coming up. You feel me? Like get the music, like as far as just the quality of the album and everything about the music, just get it back on that level. So that was something that I went in the studio on.
I definitely was like, all the beats had to be 10 times harder than what we usually do. But music overall, though, had to be 10 times harder than the mixtapes and all the other shit we did.
What
a ton of people seem to love about the album is that it's not just a bunch of songs that are singles. The album kind of tells a story. Was it something you consciously did to try to write an album with a little bit of a narrative, not just random?
No, we got all singles, though. We got like almost all, we got all singles. That's the purpose of the album, was to do all singles. You know what I'm saying? So the radio just play everything. But he painted a picture with the story. You know what I'm saying? Everybody played their part. Sycamore and him, they got together. They studied. They did their homework. Well, Sycamore, I'm sure he knew because he a little older than us. But he did his, you know what I'm saying? They did their homework. I came, brought my beats, painted the picture. Terrence Martin played on them. And we just, you know what I'm saying, came together in all the minds. You know what I'm saying? We turned up.
Everybody put their heart and their soul into this shit, man.
Yeah.
This nigga Terrence was playing what's that called? The saxophone?
Hey, Terrence charging $75,000 for a saxophone player.
Hey, was that a flute or
not
a saxophone?
Sax. And a harmonica.
That nigga was up in the booth playing that saxophone from his fucking heart. Hey, I saw that shit.
$75,000 a line for the sax.
Yeah, that's a flute?
Yeah.
Your album, The New Age, Compton Chronic.
That's what's up.
Be a timeless record.
Yeah.
Timeless record holding up for the next few decades.
Damn right.
It better.
I'd be wrong if I say it wouldn't.
I hope.
I ain't hoping.
I got faith.
In a review in a magazine I read about the album, they said it portrays life on the streets, but also details the actions of how individual decisions impact everybody else around you. Is that something that you were trying to go for, or that's just kind of...
I mean, I wasn't really trying to go for that, but that is true, though. You feel me? That's probably why a lot of... I know that is why a lot of stuff happens.
So you said the tour's been pretty crazy so far. I know you just did the 420 show out with Snoop and stuff.
In Denver, we got blowed. No, I'm just playing. We didn't have our sound because what's that shit called? Niggas gotta get put
advanced.
On blast. They didn't advance our show, so we didn't have our sound, but we put it off in the rain. Me, Terrence, and this and my nigga YG.
This nigga.
So yeah. Is this the first big like headlining tour you've ever done before?
Yeah, this is my first national headline tour. I've been touring though before, opening up for other acts. Then I've been doing my tours for my mixtapes on the West Coast, and I done went to Germany and Japan. But it ain't been this serious. You feel me? So yeah, shout out to everybody coming out to them shows, getting them tickets. You feel me? Standing outside of them lines, rain, sunny, snow, all that.
I know the next three nights are sold out. How crazy is that? Just the moment you get there, it's going to be packed up.
Turn.
Man, that's crazy.
Turn. Especially on the East Coast, man. I couldn't come out here and do shows like that and have like a good amount of people in the crowd like until now. You feel me? Last year I couldn't did that. The year before that I couldn't have did it. So it's like it's a blessing. I appreciate it all.
How did you guys first link up together?
In the streets.
Yeah, like a mutual friend. His name Big B. He introduced me, him, and Ty. And ever since then, it's been on.
You produced the whole album, right?
Yeah, majority of it.
How'd you guys choose who you wanted to bring on and feature on that album?
Sycamore. Okay. Yeah, but you know what I'm saying? He came through with the
hey,
one.
Hey, features as far as
you talking about? No, you said you talking about the beats or you talking about the features?
Both actually.
The beats was like, it was all a collective thing, you know what I'm saying? Like, it wasn't just one person that thought, you know what I'm saying? Sycamore brought
no,
Metro.
Yes,
and
yeah.
B-Weezy.
Yeah, B-Weezy
and then,
Metro.
And I want to say Sick thought about the Terrence Martin thing too, you know, and brought him in and made everything sound, you feel me, next level.
And then you guys got Q.
Oh, that was your boy. Yeah.
Oh, Sick can't get that. You said Q, what'd you say?
So then you got Schoolboy, you got Drake, you got Kendrick.
Yeah.
How those collaborations come together?
Because they was meant to be, you feel
it
me?
It was faith.
That shit was, everything that happened was supposed to happen. Don't nobody, niggas don't get Drake features with videos and clearances and shit like that. It was supposed to happen, you know? Real, yeah, never mind. I was about to say some other shit.
Nigga, shit.
How long have you been rapping for? Did you always know this was bound to be your life?
You know how people be saying you been rapping since he was two. You know how people be saying that? I've been singing, I've been DJing since I was one. You know?
Yeah, I've been rapping since I was 2 years old, and I knew this was going to happen when it happened. Yeah.
All right, aside from the upcoming dates on the rest of this tour, what else do we expect to see for you guys in the future?
We got a label situation. Me, Ty, Mustard. We partner. We own it, all three of us. You feel me? And we all going to put in that hard work and dedication to the label, get it up, running off the ground. We got artists. You feel me? We got to, yeah. We
expect
about to
the unexpected. Ain't no telling. You know what I'm saying? You never know.
They got a clue, though.
They got a little clue.
Mustard, Ty, YG, one label. Come on, my nigga. Like,
it's
dangerous right there. Yeah.
That's a lot. That's a lot of pressure on these niggas.
Yeah, man. Hey, it's YG. Thanks for watching Under the Gun TV. Make sure you get that My Crazy Life. It's in stores right now, West Coast Classic. Yeah.
What up with your boy DJ Mustard? Thanks for watching Under the Gun TV. Follow me on Twitter at DJ Mustard and Instagram. Follow all my shit. Make sure you vote for me on all the award shows. We trying to get some Grammys.
Vote for me for president 2016 yeah. to 2020.
The Red House.
The Red House. Weed is legal in every state. Motherfucking. I'ma turn the White House into a flip session. No, I'm playing.
No, bro, I'm just playing. And it's on with my nigga, my nigga, my nigga. My nigga, my nigga. My nigga, my nigga. My nigga, my nigga. My nigga, my nigga.